हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक क्लास 11 एंड क्लास 12। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अवर टॉपिक डेटाबेस क्रिएशन। स्कूल डेटाबेस वी विल क्रिएट, एंड इन दिस स्कूल डेटाबेस वी विल क्रिएट स्टूडेंट टेबल, एंड यू कैन सी SID, एस नेम, डेट ऑफ बर्थ, सिटी, पिन कोड, फीस, एंड डेटा टाइप वी कैन SID, वी कैन यूज इंटीजर, एंड प्राइमरी की वी कैन यूज, एस नेम वी कैन यूज करेक्टर 20 ऑफ ईच स्टूडेंट, करेक्टर 20 वी कैन टेन, एंड नॉट नल मीन्स वी मस्ट इनपुट स्टूडेंट नेम, डेट ऑफ बर्थ, सो यू कैन सी YYY MDDDD, एंड डेट डेटा टाइप वी कैन यूज नॉट नल मीन्स वी मस्ट इनपुट डेटा, SCT वी कैन यूज करेक्टर 15, यूनिक मीन्स वी कैन नॉट इनपुट डुप्लीकेट सिटीज, ओनली वन सिटी वी कैन यूज, एंड पिन कोड वी कैन यूज करेक्टर 6, एंड हियर वी कैन यूज डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रेंट, एंड फीस वी कैन यूज अवर डेसिमल पॉइंट डेटा, एंड चेक कंस्ट्रेंट वी कैन यूज। सो यू कैन सी प्राइमरी की कंस्ट्रेंट, नॉट नल, यूनिक, डिफॉल्ट एंड चेक कंस्ट्रेंट, ऑल द कंस्ट्रेंट वी कैन यूज वन बाय वन। सो हियर आई एम शोइंग द प्रैक्टिकली, सो हियर यू कैन सी स्टार्ट, here I am using all programs, MySQL, and you can see MySQL 5.5 command line. Okay students, so here I am using right click, property, here I am using font, here I am using Lucida console, here I am using 20. So you can see 20, this is our password. So password here I am using root, you can see here I am using root password. Okay students, now here I am using create, okay, this command here I am using. First we create database school, so I am using create database, you can see school, okay, so this command will create school database, but I want to show the school database, here I am using show databases, so this database will show the school database, you can see in this list, okay, but I want to open this school database, so here I am using use school, okay, now this time you can see school database will open, but in this school database I want to create student table, you can see, and you can see here I am using create table, here I am using create table, here I am using student, and here I am using small bracket opening and then press enter. Here I am using our first column name, you can see SID. Here I am using SID. Data type we can use integer, and constant here I am using primary key. Okay, this is our primary key constant. Here I am using comma, then press enter. Our next column you can see S name. So here I am using S name, here I am using character 20. So each student have 20 letters. Here I am using not null constraint. Not null means we must input student name. Here I am using comma. Then here I am using DOB. DOB means date of birth. Here I am using date data type. And not null means we must input date of birth. Now next thing you can see here I am scrolling this thing. Now you can see here you can see the next thing here I am using after date of birth we will include SCT column. So here I am using SCT. Here I am using character 15. Here I am using unique constraint. Here I am using unique constraint. We cannot repeat this city name. Okay. Now next thing here I am using pin code. Here pin code we can use 6. Okay. Here I am using default rule. So here we can use 313001. So this is our default pin code. So automatically we can insert directly. Okay. Now here I am using comma. Our last column you can see fees. So you can see this is your fees column. Okay, this is your fees column. So data type here I am using decimal. Okay, here I am using 7, 2. Okay, here I am using check constant. Okay, here we can specify our fees range. So you can see our fees range. You can see 4,000 and 7,000. Okay, you can see this is your fees range. 4,000 and 7,000. So here I am using 4,000 and 7,000. Here I am using the bracket. Now after this there is no column, so I am not using comma here. I am using directly press enter. Now here this is our opening brace, here I am using closing bracket. Now here I am using semicolon and then press enter. Now you can see this is our query. Okay, now I want to see the structure. Here I am using describe, table name you can see student. Now you can see the structure. SID, S name, date of birth, SCT, you can see. SID, S name, date of birth, SCT, pin code, fees, column you can see integer, character 20, date and character 15, character 6, decimal 7.2. Here you can see SID have primary key rule. Here S name have not null concept, date of birth have not null. Not null means we must input S name and date of birth. The next thing is our SCT. So SCT means this is unique. Okay, we cannot repeat city name for another student. Pin code, here default pin code is 313001. And fees, here I am using decimal point. Total before decimal point we can use 4 digit and after decimal point we can use 2 digits. So total we have 7 thing. Okay, now next thing is now next table is our, here I am using our child table. Here I am using marks table. In marks table you can see our SID column, subject column, marks, SID integer. Here I am using foreign key because this SID is completely depend on student table SID. Then we can use check constraint, then we can use marks check constraint. Here we can specify the range. Okay student, now you can see this is our next table, marks, in a student table. So here I am using marks. So here I am using new table marks. Okay, so here I am using create table. Okay, you can see here I am using marks. Okay, here I am using marks. Here I am placing opening bracket. Here I am again using SID integer. Here I am using not null. Okay, now here I am using next column subject. Okay, this is your next column subject. Here I am using character. Here I am using 20. Okay, now here I am using check constraint. Here I am decide our subject name is already fixed. Here I am using Hindi and we can use English. Okay students, so you can see our Hindi and English. Then we can use comma, then press enter. Here I am using marks. Marks in here I am using integer value. Here again I am using check constraint. So here I am using marks is greater than 40 and marks less than 70. Here I am using opening closing bracket and comma. Then press enter. Now this SID is completely depend on student table SID. This marks table SID completely depend on student table SID. So here SID we can use as a foreign key. So here I am using foreign key, foreign, foreign key. Here I am using SID. Here I am using references. Here I am using references. Here I am using student. Here I am using SID. So you can see this SID is our foreign key, but this SID is completely depend on student SID. So we can use references student ID. Okay student, now here I am using on update cascade, on update cascade, and here I am using on delete cascade. Okay, here I am using our engine is equal to InnoDB. Okay students, so here we must use on update cascade, on delete cascade. Means when you change the SID in our student table, so automatically change in marks table. When you delete this SID in student table, so automatically delete in the marks table. okay students, so you can see our SID column. Okay, you can see our SID column, subject column and marks column. Okay, you can see SID here, SID integer, marks character 20 integer. Here SID subject only, we have two subject, Hindi or English, so we must input Hindi or English. Okay, so this check constant always check. Okay, when you input other subjects, it will not accept. Or we must input marks between 40 to 70 in the marks column. So we can use check constraint. And our in this marks table, SID is our foreign key, but this SID is completely depend on student table SID. And when you change in student table SID, so automatically update. When you delete, so automatically delete in our marks table. So here I am using in closing bracket, engine is equal to InnoDB. We must use this line, engine is equal to InnoDB. Otherwise our foreign key concept will not work, because our default engine is ISAM. So this default engine cannot provide foreign key concept. So here I am using our new engine, engine is equal to InnoDB. So this engine will provide foreign key concept and referential integrity rules. So finally here I am pressing the enter key. Now you can see our engine is okay. Now here I am using describe marks. Now you can see here student ID integer. Here you can see multiple means this is your foreign key, and here subject and marks, and data type you can see character 20 integer 11. Okay students, now here I want to input data in our student table. Okay, so first here I am using describe student. So you can see this is our student table, but I want to input record. So you can see these are our records, 101 Rohit, date of birth, and this is our second record, and this is our third record. So we can input this record one by one. So here you can see this command, insert into. Here I am using insert into student. Here I am using column name SID comma S name comma DOB comma SCT comma pin code comma fees. Okay, so you can see here I am using this command. Here I am using values 101 comma, here I am using Rohit. Okay, then we can input our date of birth. Okay, so you can see our date of birth, you can see our city, you can see here I am using Kota, and here you can see our pin code, and finally we can input our fees and press enter. Now next data we can use this data I want to insert, 102 Hitesh, and this data I want to insert. So here we can use again insert into. Here I am using into student. Here we can use SID comma. Again here I am using S name comma date of birth comma SCT comma pin code, and here I am using fees. Okay, here I am using values. Here I am using 102 comma, here I am using Hitesh comma, here I am using date of birth 9306, here I am using 11, here I am using city Pali, here I am using our pin code, you can see 313002. Here I am using our new fees 00, this fees. Okay students, now you can see this is our fees. So you can see this is our fees. So here I am using control C. Okay students, so here again I want to start all programs, and here you can see here I am using MySQL and command line program. Here again I am inputting the password root. Here I am using password root. Here I am using table again use school. Now you can see our show tables. Here I am using show tables. We have two tables, so first we are using select star from student. Okay, now you can see here we have only one record. Now I want to input second record. Okay, so here I am using insert into. Here I am using again student. Here I am using SID comma S name comma DOB. Here I am using SCT comma. Here I am using pin code comma fees. here I am using again values. So you can see here I am using 102. Okay, here again I am inputting Hitesh, comma, we can use 19306. Here I am using 11. Here I am using Pali district. Here we can use 313002. And here I am using fees. Okay, this fees we can input. Now data is too long in pin code. Okay, student. So we can input our directly we can input our data insert into here I am using student. Okay, here I am using directly using values. Here I am using 102. Here I am using Hitesh. Okay, here I am using 11306. Here I am using this date of birth. Here I am using Pali. We can and here I am using 313002 and here we can use this data I want to input again. Okay, so here I am using this data without column name we can directly use. Now last record is our insert into here I am using student, here I am using values, here I am using 103, here I am using Rita, here I am using 198, here I am using 05, here I am using 12, okay, here I am using Desh 12, comma, here I am using Jaipur, okay, here I am using default, here I am using default, okay. Now here we can use this command, okay. So here again we have some error. Here I am using insert into. Here we can use insert into, okay. Now you can see here you can see insert into. So we have three records, 101 Rohit, 102 Hitesh and 102 Rita. So you can see select star from we can use student. Now you can see we have three records. Okay, now another table we have, we know very well, marks table. So marks table we have three records, three columns we have. So in marks table we can use this data, 101 Hindi, 101 English, because 101 is our Rohit. Rohit have two subject, Hindi and English, and 102 have Hitesh. Hitesh have two subject, Hindi and English. So I want to insert this data. So you can see this is our coding. So here I am using, simply we can use this data. Here I am using this thing. Here I am using insert into marks. Here I am using directly we can use values. Here I am using 101 comma, here I am using Hindi. Okay, here I am using 80. Okay, now here I am pressing the enter key. Now here again I am using the same thing, but here I am using English, but here I am inputting the marks 70. Okay, now next here I am using 102, but here I am using Hindi. Now marks is our 40. Now next thing we again here I am using the subject last English, but here I am using 50. Now you can see here I am using select star from here I am using marks. Now you can see this is our marks. Okay. Now here I am using select star from, here I am using student. Okay, now here I am using select star from marks. So we have both table. Okay, so you can see our student table and marks table you can see. So dear student, today I am discussing about some advanced topic. Okay, now you can see this is our student table, this is our column names and our different kind of constraints, primary key, not key, here I am using, and this is our second table, marks table, but here marks column, SID column is completely, this SID column depend on our student table SID, so this is our foreign key. So here 101, 101 we can repeat, foreign key we can repeat, because a student have multiple subjects. Okay students, thank you so much.